yes, this is a bit of excessive content, but first, let's congratulate VidIQ, a YouTuber from the San Francisco in California, who, at time recording, recently just hit 500,000 subscribers and dedicated a huge live stream to that. When I edit all my videos, I will post a link in the description linking his channel, like, like, you see that? It's 532. At the time that I just showed you, well, guess what? It was 529 when he hit it, and it was and, like, the live stream chat was going crazy over it. Yes, he did have a lot of drawbacks, like, when I came on initially, he only had 73 more. Somehow that increased to 82, but it doesn't really matter now. The last time I checked, he had 500,014 subs. He could have easily had way more subs. Like, what I say in the chat, if it was a race from Moscow to Jersey City, we're in Newark. And I believe, because really Jersey City and Newark aren't that far. New York and Newark aren't that far. Although the airports are both kind of far. They're both around 15 minutes from Times Square, no traffic, so around half an hour to each other. We are saying both JFK and LaGuardia Airport. And really, I just mentioned VidIQ because I want to have a rough transition. I didn't want to have a rough transition, so I mentioned that comparison I made in the live stream chat. But we are going to talk today about like New York's geography, the New York metro area. We're going to divide this up though into four videos: New York itself. And there will be no coronavirus mentions. New York itself, Long Island, the Hudson Valley, and Northern New Jersey. And other videos will be coming out about, like, you know, Northern New Jersey. It's called North Jersey, then the Central Jersey, which is also part of the metro area. We're also going to be mentioning the Lehigh Valley in a less detailed video, and Western Connecticut. The Lehigh Valley is the Allentown metro area. Despite the city itself being small, it extends into New Jersey. So it's actually in two states. Oh my God. This is the main video, part one of four. Will I use those like names that you traditionally use? I won't use them by itself, but if it's combined, I will use it. Those, like, those borough names instead of the county names. No, for Queens and the Bronx, it does not really matter. So we're actually going to start off with Richmond County, which in a lot of people's opinion should be part of New Jersey. It has four bridges to four separate counties. The Bayonne Bridge on NY 440, which connects to New Jersey 440, connects to Hudson County, which is one of the densest counties as well as smallest counties in the United States. There's the Gothel's Bridge on Interstate 278, which connects to Union County, New Jersey. And finally, on NY 440, which connects to New Jersey Route 440, we have the Outer Bridge. By the way, if you're wondering, when I make this video, yes, I am aware I don't exactly know what, like, North, what counties are actually officially part of North Jersey. I will, however, look that up. So, Richmond County isn't really the bustling metropolitan type that you'd expect New York City with all those gridlocked, crammed streets. It's actually kind of open because, you have exits into a lot of streets, but you don't have a lot of bustling expressways. In fact, realistically, past exit 9, you literally have one way in or out. And realistically, all 440 is there for is, like, if you want to have a quick and easy connection to, like, let's say, from Middlesex to Hudson County, like, that's what you'd use it for. A lot of people also, like, when they go from, like, eastern New Jersey to central New Jersey, like, extreme northeastern New Jersey, they might also go from the Bay on and then take the exit onto 278 and then take the Gothels. That's a bit more common and understandable. The Gothels is in the northern part of it. Bayonne is pretty central. If you're going from Richmond County to some parts of New York, like, it depends on where you're going. In some cases, yes, you take the Verrazano Bridge on 278 to Kings, just take that. That's typically useful, I'd say, if you want to go to Long Island or the rest of New York City. Although New York County might be an exception because you take 278, then you take exit 25 onto 478, which immediately takes you into the Hugh L. Carey Tunnel. But really, in between, which, by the way, if you're wondering, yes, one time when we came back from New York, from my cousin's house in New Jersey, I am telling you that it was so packed on the if we would have taken Richmond County, so I'm not joking. We took the New Jersey Turnpike all the way out to exit 16, even though it's the Lincoln Tunnel, and then figured our way out through in New York County from there. Was everyone Holland Tunnel? Yes, but only a couple of times in my life, and I really wanted a video of the Holland Tunnel, but I forgot to make one along with the GGW Bridge, the Throgs Neck Bridge, the Kogzewski Bridge, like all these, and the Manhattan Bridge. I really wanted to make videos of all these bridges, but I forgot to. I did make one of the Alexander Hamilton Bridge, if you were wondering. Promise I'm gonna make a lot more content. Promise. If you're going to lower New York County, you might take the Holland Tunnel instead and then take 440 to 78. However, I'd say, like, if you're going to upstate, now, where I live, you might even consider going to New Jersey there, but especially there, because, like, you only have to go on the Bayonne, you only have to go through two counties in New Jersey, Hudson and Budgen to get to Rockland County. In New York, you have to go through Kings County, you have to go through New York County, the Bronx County, and Westchester County. Which, by the way, I kind of hoped they would build a bridge from Richmond County to New York County, but they didn't. Anyway, Kings. So if you're wondering, New York metropolitan gridlock type is in the north, where the neighborhood downtown of Brooklyn is. However, Southern Kings can have a lot of traffic too by the Belt. So, like, you're the Belt and 278, and those are like the two major giants crashing down on you here. I mean, yeah, you also have NY27. But yeah, that's really it. Not much more to say, but it's funnily enough, even though Queens is generally to the northeast, there's a part of Queens that's south, even southwest of it, known as the Rockaways, which I hope they'll build a bridge to Richmond County, but they just never did. Connecticut has no bridge from the Sandy Hook Peninsula in New Jersey, either to Coney Island, or to the Rockaways itself. The Belt does not directly go into Rockaways, and it's like really funny, because like Flatbush Avenue almost goes to the, to the Manhattan Bridge, but it ends at 278, and if you go south, you'll eventually hit the Marine Park Bridge, which goes to the Rockaways in Queens, so, that's funny, haha, funny. Queens definitely has a lot more highways, though, but it's not really the metropolitan gridlock type that you'd expect. I'd say, although it can get pretty packed on 495 there. I've had plenty of experiences where even from the QMT, it took an hour and a half to get home. Because here's the thing, like in New York City, it could, in Queens, it can be very packed. Because, I mean, if you think about it, you really only have three effective ways to get from New Jersey to New York via New York County. And this is like the primary one for getting to Queens. If you want to use King, just take the Holland. And if you want to go to the Bronx, just take the GW. But that's why, like, even though the GW bridge has horrible reputations in traffic, it's really just because it's very, very accident prone. Like you can expect to get into a lot of accidents on there. Whereas with the QMT and like 495 and all that, like it's not really that much accident prone. Plus, even though they sound connected, they really aren't. Like, you have to go down to 34th Street, which is why 34th Street is so important, along with Southern to like Madison Square Garden. Speaking of which, New York County, while it only has two major expressways on the west and east side, and a couple of more that just barge in rudely, it's like the really metropolitan, like, pack type that you'd expect. So much so that in 2021, they're introducing a toll to any cars that come south of 59th Street. 59th Street, where the Edcott's Queensboro Bridge on NY25 comes in. 25, if you're wondering, goes all the way out to Orient Point, where then it takes a ferry into New London, Connecticut. New London's kind of like where you like see the New England ferry hub, because it also has, because you could also connect on a ferry to like Rhode Island. There's one to Montauk, one to Fishers Island, New York, which, by the way, even though it's a part of Suffolk County, you actually have to go through Connecticut to access it, because it's only available by ferry, and the only ferry that goes there leaves from Connecticut. So it kind of feels more like Connecticut now. It's like, it's kind of like Liberty Island and Ellis Island. But you have to go through New Jersey waters, and for Ellis Island, New Jersey, to get from New York to New York. Except it's with Connecticut. But yeah, New York County can be bustling, especially lower in Midtown. Once you get past, I'd say, past 59th, it's not so bad. But until 59th, it's pretty bad. Yeah, you'll probably make a whole video on that itself, and in the Bronx. It's so complicated, because the Bronx, at some points, can be really metropolitan, really urban, and at some points, the Bronx doesn't even feel like New York City. It feels like you're in Westchester, because Bronx is like the gateway from New York City to the Hudson Valley, which then expands out to the rest of New York. If you're wondering, Westchester borders five counties. The Bronx, Fairfield County, Connecticut, Orange County, Rockland County, and Putnam County. So, I'm telling you though, like, 95 in the Bronx can't really backed up, because you would not believe it. Sometimes GW bridge traffic comes all the way after the Brooklyn Exchange. I'm not kidding. Like one time we were going to the Bronx Zoo, really trafficked on 295. Guess what? GW bridge traffic, because there was an accident there, and it would take 2 hours to cross it and 2 hours to even get to there. I'm telling you, like, but that's why on 295, sometimes they say take, instead of just taking 95 all the way there, you take I-278 to the Bronx, then you take exit 47 on IE7 North, then you take exit 7 South on I-95 South, and then you take 95, and sometimes that could actually be faster. That's about it for New York City. I don't really have any more auto-generated facts on my sleeve. We're gonna make a lot of videos on this series. So this is part one of either four, if you include the quarterback videos. However, this could also be part one of seven, depending on how you look at it. And like, this is long. Like, these videos, like my videos, except for like my road videos and my introduction videos and the videos you just make because I'm running out, and the videos I make because I'm running out of battery, but I need to get some content out. These are long videos. I mean, I hope you know that, but these are not meant to be short videos. When I start calling out the subject, well, it's just like, because we're basically quarantined. There's like so much to do. Then we're going to talk. I'm actually going to make another video quickly about the six links. just crossed 20 minutes. There's 6 links from New York to New Jersey. I'm gonna make a video on that. And then just another video about all the bridges inside New York City, because like there's a lot of water there. Anyway, bye.